Well, earlier this year, an estimated 16,000 fish fans descended on Bangor for a concert at Darling's waterfront pavilion. And now, a city closer to home is considering a proposal for a similar outdoor concert venue. Well, South Portland has one of the most visited parks in southern Maine, Buck Lake Park, with its iconic lighthouse and beautiful views of Casco Bay.
Yes, WMTW News 8's Jim Keithley is live at Buck Lake Park tonight with some new information about the concert venue proposal. Jim.
Well, of course, a lot of people are familiar with Buck Lake Park, as you know, Steve, because you live not too far from here. There's the iconic lighthouse right over here. Big plans to transform this area into an outdoor concert venue to be situated between the Liberty Ship Memorial there and the Portland Pipeline Pier. Some say it's the perfect spot to play host to 8 to 10,000 people. The expansive area in South Portland known as Buck Lake Park. It could soon become the biggest concert venue around. City planners released this artist rendering showing what an outdoor waterfront amphitheater might look like.
8 to 10,000 people. Here? Like, near my house. Are they going to be on my lawn?
Not on her lawn, but yes, just down the road in the Spring Point neighborhood of South Portland. The area already has several restaurants, a bar, a community college, and plenty of residents. But the hope is to create a venue that will rival the successful waterfront concert series in Bangor, which is drawing A-list acts.
That we could probably sell more pizza.
Katie Pataki owns 158 Pickett Street Cafe and says anytime you bring 8 to 10,000 people into the area, it's good for business.
Incredible thing to be able to see that sort of, you know, energy down here and that many more people actually even knowing that we are here.
The concert venue idea is just that, an idea. In the very early stages, the city leases part of the park owned by Portland Pipeline. The company would have to write off on the idea too, but nobody was available for comment today. And then there's the issue of parking and traffic. For 5,000 people turned out in July for the color run without any major problems, said the city's police chief. Still, some residents are taking a wait-and-see attitude.
I'm a believer, I think, in allowing it to happen. If under the auspices, if it doesn't work, if it is a congestion, knowing at that point that the city can pull the trigger and say, look, we tried it, it's not going to work.
The city's economic development director says if all goes as planned, we could be enjoying waterfront concerts right here as early as next summer. We're live in South Portland tonight, Jim Keithley, WMTW News 8.